fans. Welcome to Friday Night Varsity Preview. I'm Rachel George, joined by sports editor Dan Spears. It is state championship week, and we've got one team left. So this is the All Wallace Rose Hill Show.
All Wallace, all the time.
That's right. The Bulldogs into the state championship for the first time since 2005. We'll face Mount Airy there. Certainly the matchup we picked when the brackets came out.
Yes.
What do you think about this game?
I think that, like you said, this is the game everybody wanted to see. This is the game everybody's going to get to see. Mm-hmm. It's going to be a good one. Mm-hmm. I think everybody involved should be very happy to get there. And now they're going to... Somebody's taking home a state championship.
That's right. Well, certainly the Bulldogs plowed their way through the East to get there. If you ask me, they didn't play a good team in the bunch.
No,
averaging more than 40 points in the playoffs, giving up less than a touchdown. This is going to be their toughest test. How do they try to handle a Mount Airy team that won the state championship last year and has won 31 games in a row?
Well, two things. One, you said, yeah, they did not play the greatest competition in the world, but it's the playoffs, and this is when weird things happen. And Wallace didn't let a weird thing happen to them. They went out and beat the people.
Yes.
And those were, every time we look up at the scoreboard, it's Wallace 21-0 and it's in the first quarter. I mean, they went out and took care of business. I don't see why that changes when you play a good team. I think they've got the mindset going. We talked about it a little bit last week that they have the it. That whatever that it is, they've got it right now. And there's no reason for them to lose it at this point, whether it's, a not so good team like North Edgecombe or a really good team like Mount Airy on the other side. I think they just need to go out and do what they've done. And there's nothing else for them to do at this point.
Exactly. And, normally when we get to this level of the playoffs, you start talking about teams and getting overwhelmed by the stage of it, playing in a college stadium in front of a lot of fans. The turf will be different. The stadium will be different. But there's tons of fans in the dog pound every week. I don't think the crowd is going to really be a factor for them. I know Coach Joey Price is a little worried about the turf. But Scott Braswell played there 2 years ago when they won it and said, you'll adjust, it'll be fine, it'll feel just like a game. Definitely, they want to win this one. Mount Airy is a good team, though. Like I said, 31 wins in a row, won it last year. I was surprised, though, in the Western Final, they had Robbinsville and had to come back to beat Robbinsville, which is a team I've had ranked below Wallace for about the last month of the season. So not as perfect a team as we thought. Definitely something that the Bulldogs can win, but going to have to continue playing the way they have been.
The interesting part, and you'll read about it more in the Star News and at Star News Online this week, we're actually going to be exchanging stories with the Mount Airy News, talking about some of their players, their matchups, and things like that. Their best player, Luke Wheeler, is the conference player of the year. His brother before him last year was the conference player of the year when Mount Airy won a state championship. He hurt his hand in that in the West Final. Apparently, according to Thomas Smith's story from the Mount Airy News, he couldn't even buckle his chin strap with his own right hand. His teammates were doing it for him. Wow. He's their best player. He's running back, wide receiver on offense, middle linebacker on defense, does everything for them. It might have been just him not being at 100%. Apparently, everything on their offense and defense runs through him. He's got over 100 tackles, 8 sacks, 4 picks, over 1,000 yards rushing, over 500 yards receiving. I mean, this kid does it all for them, and when you tend to put all your eggs in one basket like that, things can go a little haywire, which I suspect is what happened against Robbinsville.
Right.
That's not Wallace's problem.
No.
They have a lot of weapons, and I think that's going to be their big advantage this week.
Yeah, and you're absolutely right. Balance is the key. 3 rushers over 1,000 yards for them, Omar Carr, Bobby Crawford, and Devontae Herring. When we were writing about the defenses last week for the Eastern Finals, they have 4 or 5 guys right at 100 tackles and some pretty close to it. So they, there's no one guy you have to take out of the equation. You have to, completely oppress that offense and that defense, and that's difficult for teams to do. We'll see if Mount Airy can do it.
And I think the other thing is the kids from Wallace have figured out that, yeah, it might not be my week, but it's going to be somebody else's.
Right.
When Omar Carr struggles, Herring struggles. Herring struggles, Crawford strong. When somebody says, okay, we're going to put 9 in the box, well, DeJuan McKenzie throws it over the top of them and they still lose. I think that's going to be Mount Airy's big problem is what do you pick to stop at this point? And I don't know if you can stop all the pieces.
Right. Well, we'll certainly see how it goes. That game is Saturday at noon at BB&T Field at Wake Forest University. We will, of course, be there with highlights, everything. We will have a live blog, so if you can't make the trip, check out starnewsvarsity.com. I would be remiss if I did not remind people for our Southwest Onslow fans, they also have made it to the state championship. We'll be at the same place at BB&T at 4 p.m. on Saturday. And as Dan just told me, if you buy tickets for the Wallace game, you can stay and watch a Southwest Onslow game. So I'm sure some of you Southwest Onslow fans will get there early and watch a good game in the small 1A. Like I said, highlights, game coverage, we'll have it all this week at Star News Varsity. Be sure to check it out there and on the blog. But for this week, for Dan Spears and myself, Rachel George, this has been Friday Night Varsity Preview on StarNewsOnline.com.